Guys, Meg here, and in this video we are going to have a look at some singer-songwriter essentials, things that you might need in your singer-songwriter gig and studio kit, maybe give you some inspiration for your stocking fillers as Christmas is just around the corner. There's different applications you may need to use all of these different things I've got behind me for, but I'm going to start with one of the most important points of a singer-songwriter's gear list, which would be live equipment. I assume if you're watching this video, then you may be a bit like myself, a gigging musician who writes their own songs, sings, plays an instrument, and goes out to live shows. Well, obviously one of the first things that you're gonna need in your equipment list is a microphone. If you've been gigging a while, you might know that most venues do have microphones on hand, but they tend to prefer you bring your own microphone. This is for many different reasons. It's obviously really hygienic to have your own microphone. You have no idea how many people have sung into the same microphone before you. It also means you have a bit of control over your vocal sound. Each microphone might suit different styles a bit better, so if you get to choose your mic and bring it with you, you know you're always going to have the same sound. This microphone that I've been using in this video is the Shure SM58, which I'd say is probably the industry standard. You're going to find this microphone at most live venues and concerts across the country. That's because they are sturdy, they sound great, and they don't break. This microphone is relatively inexpensive and should last you a long time. So if you are looking for a microphone to choose, I can always vouch for the Shure SM58. With a microphone, of course, you are going to need some accessories for your live show. So that would be a mic stand and some XLR cables. This is essential if you want to look like a professional musician when you are touring. Although some venues might have the mic stands, it looks extra great on your part if you bring all of this with you. So next on your list as a gigging musician, if you are a guitarist like myself, as a lot of singer-songwriters are, you might be gigging in venues and find that your acoustic guitar or your electric guitar sounds slightly different from venue to venue. This could be down to many factors, different PA systems, different sound engineers, different desks, everyone EQing things slightly differently, and it can be super frustrating to never get the same sound from your acoustic pickup. For this reason, the next thing I would recommend checking out and getting on your singer-songwriter list would be some pedals. Now, if you are an acoustic guitarist, then you don't have to go crazy with pedals. There's a lot of different ones out there, but you really only need a small amount to really change that sound. On this board that I've got over here, I've got four pedals that I would take as a staple out to all my gigs. These are from the Big Top range of pedals, which are super affordable, budget friendly, but also sound great. So first in line, I've got a tuner. Obviously this will be handy no matter where you're playing, so you can bypass the signal. People don't have to hear you tuning up as it will mute the sound. Next in line you have a compressor. This will just help to tighten the sound a little bit. There's quite a noticeable difference when you turn this pedal on and off from what happens when you do add that compressor to your chain. I'd highly recommend having a play around with a compressor if you haven't before and just seeing how much it lifts your acoustic sound. And then next two on the pedal board are some acoustic guitar essentials. Reverb, which has got many different reverb patterns you can choose from. I had mine on plate, which was quite a full sound, but you can choose between hall, room, flanger, and loads of different options. Reverb is also a great tool to have with your acoustic guitar. It adds a lot more room and depth to your sound. You could also, if you wanted to, add a delay pedal on your chain. This again will just help to lift the sound even more. I'll give you a demonstration at some point so you can hear the difference between all of these pedals when they're on and off, and hopefully that will inspire you a little to lift your acoustic guitar sound. And as I said, this just means you have a bit more control over your live sound when you are gigging, something that can be a little frustrating if it does differ all the time. If you are looking at pedals to put on your gigging pedal board and you've tried out some of the more budget-friendly options and you know you're set on a certain sound, if you wanted to look at something a bit more advanced, then you could take a look at something like the Marine Layer Reverb from Fender. This just gives you a few more options than the smaller pedals and you've got a bit more scope of sound to play with. So it might be worth getting yourself down to a PMT store and plugging all these in so you can hear it for yourself. Obviously, if you've got yourself some pedals, then you are going to need a pedal board. So that would be the next thing on my list, along with a power supply. There's a few different ways that you can power up pedals. You could go with 9-volt power supply DCs, one for each pedal, but admittedly, it's a little bit of a faff. So the main thing you want to look into is a power bank. There's lots of different ones out there and most pedals tend to be powered by 9-volt DC, so you can get yourself a relatively small and easy to use one. There's a big top power bank you could look into if you just want something affordable to get you started. Or on my sound today, I'm using an ISO brick from MXR. This just gave me a few more options, and if you were using high voltage pedals, something needing an 18-volt, then this ISO brick will have that as well. So there you go, you've got all of your options for getting a great sound when you're gigging. The next things on my list will be some things for your home studio. Okay, so if you are like myself and you are a singer-songwriter who likes writing songs at home, I'd assume that you'd probably want to get some of these songs recorded. If you are new to home recording and you are a DIY artist, meaning you do it all yourself and you don't have access to recording studios, then with just a few items you can get yourself sounding like a pro. First thing you are going to need though, which would be the fourth thing on my essential singer-songwriter list, would be an interface. This is the Trumix TM12, which is a two-channel studio interface. It's nice and easy to use. It's USB in, so you can use it with your Mac or laptop, whichever you're using. It also has two channels, so you can run guitar and vocals or keyboard and vocals at the same time if you wanted to. You can also use a condenser microphone, which I'll get to in a minute, as it has 48 volt phantom power. These are nice and easy to use with your setup, so you just need to plug in some headphones or some speakers to hear back when you're mixing. But this will be the first thing that will get you going with home recording. So we had a look at dynamic microphones that you use on stage. Although you can use these for recording, I'd say it'd be worth looking into a condenser microphone for your home studio setup. These do differ slightly from the Shure SM58 style microphone. Condensers are a lot more sensitive and will pick up more nuances in your voice. This is obviously ideal for recording as you want to pick up the best sound possible of your singing. Also, you want it to sound as close to a professional recording studio as you can possibly get. So all you'll need to do is get yourself a condenser mic like one of the ones behind me. This one at the top, the MPM1000U, is a USB microphone that's very affordable, budget friendly and easy to use. USB mics essentially mean that you can plug it straight into your laptop. You don't need the interface in between if you are recording on the go. If you do want something a little more studio quality, then you could have a look into something like the Rode NT1. These are a little bit more expensive, but they'll give you a real crisp and clear sound on your vocals. These mics could also be used for acoustic guitar or if you are miking up any other strings or acoustic instruments. Generally, rule of thumb with recording guitars, especially acoustics, is you're going to get a far better sound if you mic up the actual acoustic than if you use the line in. Obviously, just gives you a more natural scope of what the acoustic guitar sounds like. And if you've spent money getting your favourite guitar, then you're going to want it to sound as close to that on your recording as possible. So with all of the different polar patterns that come on this microphone, you've got endless options of how you can set up your mic and use it for different applications. So I'd say they're my top things that you'll need to get started with recording at home. There's some other accessories though that you could add on at this point that are going to make your life a little easier and are going to be quite fun to play with. This is a pop filter. If you are a vocalist and you've had any mess around with microphones before for recording, you will know that one of the main problems when you get the track onto your device is that there seems to be too many hisses, P's, S's that come through on the mic. These inexpensive little tools that hook onto your microphone help to cut out all of those annoying sounds that come through your natural voice. If you get yourself one of these, get it onto your microphone, then you are one step closer to getting that studio quality vocal sound, which is what I'd imagine we're all aiming for. So if you've got all that set up, you've got all the cables you need, you've got your interface and your laptop going, then the next thing you might want to look at just for some fun is something like a MIDI controller. This MPK Mini behind me by Akai is a great tool if you want to start experimenting with more sounds on your track. If you're an acoustic guitarist and a vocalist, then this is an easy way and inexpensive way to mess around with other instruments on your tracks. I know when I'm writing music at home, I'm often hearing full band in my head or a string section or a drum beat, but it's just me and my guitar and my voice, and it's not a lot you can do with that. If you get yourself a little MIDI controller, then you can set that up to be so many different instruments. Because they work on MIDI, you play the notes and it will translate to whatever sound you've selected. You could use this, for example, to create a string section on your tracks. You could use it to create drum beats or even just a piano or a synth. All of this adds a lot of texture to your track and your sound. So this is another thing I would say is essential to your singer-songwriter's gear list. And lastly, these are all the big fun things that you'll need to get going, but it's worth mentioning that if you are a gigging musician, there are a few other things that will be a necessity to make sure you look like a pro. These are things like a gig bag, so you're not carrying your guitar on your back without a case. You're going to need yourself a tuner. This is the plug-in tuner type, but you can also get yourself inexpensive clip-on tuners if you want something that's easy to use. Other things like a capo, for example, if you're going to use one with a live show, then make sure you always bring yours with you in your equipment. And another thing that could be useful is a guitar stand. It looks professional when you have your guitar behind you on the stage, up on a stand before you're about to play. That was a rundown of all of the essential items you should get if you are a singer-songwriter in your equipment setup. If you think there's anything I've missed, let me know in the comments. And if you liked any of these bits and you haven't used them before, then you can also let us know where you'll be using these and if you think this would be useful to add to your singer-songwriter setup. I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you have, then give it a big like and subscribe to the channel. Come find us over on our socials at Play Music Today. I've been Meg and I will see you all very soon.